Hello again, everyone. Welcome back to Icewind Dale. Let's head back into, what is it? Malavon's place? Palace? Dome? Whatever.
Of course.
Let's see. Blinds for Vneblin. I suppose Blinds for Vneblin, I mean, that is a good way to keep them from being, confused by the Umber Hulks, I suppose. I didn't even think about that, actually. You know what, maybe I should use that. Do that.
I see.
And let's see. Alright, so there's an Umber Hulk there. Should probably be detecting traps right now. An inanimate body floating in an unhealthy-looking fluid. A small tarnished bronze plaque below their tube reads, Myco Hulk E. Failed after 10 days, 10 hours, 3 minutes. Diseased. Are you trying to combine Umber Hulks and Myconids? Oh, that's just gross. D. Failed after 2 minutes. Missing heart. Failed after 3 days, 1 hour, 43 minutes. Cause of death unknown. Failed after 1 day, 13 hours, 10 minutes, lung capacity insufficient. Failed after 2 hours, 12 minutes, brain stem immature. Let's see. One is a diamond surrounding two hands bound with red cord. The other is a circumscribed eye. The strange mushrooms are much larger than normal. They are slick with moisture. You. Oh, joy. Iron golems. And there is Malavon. Well, I do have that, Rod of Smiting. What is it? A Rod of Strike. Rod of Smiting, yeah. Alright, well, let's murder this guy. Seriously, it's not dead yet. Okay, there we go. That's better. For now, let's hand over that Umber Hulk shell and swap those again.
Agreed.
Actually, let's go with that. There we go.
Understood.
Oops.
At once.
Actually, let's reposition slightly, and quick save. How big is this place? This is about all of the area, so... Hello?
Take one more step and these slaves will die. You see the golems to each side of me? They are more than capable of killing all of these pathetic creatures.
Hold on, I'm not going anywhere. Just don't kill or hurt the slaves. What's your problem? Too afraid to fight me one-on-one? Eh, you're bluffing. You think I care about your stupid slaves? Go ahead and kill them. It'll just give me more time to get to you. What's your problem? Too afraid to fight me one-on-one? Yeah, let's try that.
No, not really. I just like using morality against people. I also like watching these worms die. Why not combine the two? It's fun for everyone. Well, maybe just for me. I don't know. I haven't been out of here much recently. Why should I? I can see everything from here. I am always watching! Watching!
You're crazy.
You're already boring me with your crazy talk. I think that I'll be setting the standards for sanity around here, thank you.
Do sane people cut out the eyes of dozens of gnomes?
They were staring at me, damn you! They were always watching, just as you are watching. My sisters were always watching, too. Only Gina still has her eyes just so that she could see Marketh leering over her.
Okay, fine. You've convinced me. You'll kill them, crazy bastard. What do you want me to do?
Okay, drop your weapons. Drop them! Drop any wands or potions you have, too. We wouldn't want to hurt the precious little pathetics for Neblin. Now would we?
You're crazy. Oh. That's going back. I changed my mind. You're dead.
You're no fun at all. Oh well, Matron Mother always said there'd be times like this. Ha ha ha! Die!
Oh, are you actually a drow? Okay. Let's see. There's an Umber Hulk back there. Sverb Neblin, you guys might want to run, but for now... Poke! So he's trying to cast Magic Missile. You... are attacking an iron golem, that's good.
Watch me work.
Oh good, there's some stuff there.
God grant me strength.
And yep, the oh, what did you just cast? Did you cast Iron Golem? No? They're dying from something. Your weapon is ineffective because you're attacking an iron golem. That is not the wisest of thing. Oh, wait. I was on the wrong person. There we go. Alright, where is Malavon? Malavon is badly injured already. And unfortunately, Islandwee is already confused. You are attacking there. That's good. Crow's target is gone. Good. He's dead. Your next target is an Umber Hulk.
Onward to victory!
And now you're confused. Great. I don't really have much that I can use on... the Iron Golems, but I might be able to do something about the Umber Hulks. Oh god, you are in bad shape, and I can't do anything about it. And I don't think Magic Missile is going to do anything on the Iron Golems. Are you out of your confusion? No, you are. You're gonna die.
No.
Yep, alright. Let's load it up. Our quick save. Alright. So, I'm not sure what we might be able to do about preventing the gnomes from dying. But... let's see. Righteous Wrath of the Faithful. Stone Skin. Stone Skin and... with Hope. Oh, whoops. I forgot to actually target it. There we go. Let's see.
Ready for action.
What do I have that might really do a good job of protecting us from confusion? Recitation. that'll work. I don't care about affecting enemies. What about you? What else do you have? Haste isn't going to be cumulative. I could do Trollish Fortitude on someone. But I think we're okay for now. What about you? Nothing else that I think is really going to do all that much good. Tempted to improve invisible her and try and backstab him, but that's not going to do a whole lot of good, and I don't think we could backstab the golems. Alright. And did say that prayer was cumulative. Let's chant. That's prayer. Alright. Well, let's see how this goes.
At once.
Hold on, I'm not going anywhere. Don't hurt the slaves. Fine, I'll do it. Did that actually... Oh, wow. That did actually put all of our stuff down on the ground. That's... Are you the only one? Yeah, you are the only one. Okay, let me, let's take all the stuff back. Of course, now he's lost some hit points because of that. Well, at least it lets me do this, despite, you know, sort of technically being in combat. I don't think I was using that. Wasn't using that. Did have that one there. Some sort of action. So Aminator's Legacy. Let's switch to that. Now one of those does more damage against just in general. 1d12 plus 4. Well, that's plus 4, too, so it shouldn't matter. Let's see. Yeah, we've got Debian's Rod of Smiting equipped. Alright. Start with that. You go attack.
Well.
Oops. That's fine. You... Why did you not get that off cast? Okay, you go attack that one. Why are you not getting that cast? Because you're just having trouble getting to him, I guess. Alright, he's dead now. Target number Hulk. Target gone. Alright. Go after that one. Doesn't look like we... killed Umber Hulk with that fireball. Let me swap to that. And I don't think he's going to be doing a whole lot of damage to the Iron Golem's weapon in effect. But Iron Golem death, there we go. And looks like about it. Alright, some of the Seraph Neblin did
onward
die on us, unfortunately. Oh!
Ah, what an excellent job you did of disposing of my simulacrum. It took me a long time to make him, but money is no object when the suffering of others is of the greatest reward.
Oh.
Sablik Tan always thought he was the master of magic. Always turning me away, always sending his precious, stinking Orogs after my little Umberhulks, training them to kill my pets on sight. I had the last laugh, though, when I turned him into an Umberhulk and placed him among his twisted creations. And now, for meddling in my affairs, you will suffer a similar fate. You've butchered my servants and wrecked my home. The tide turns now!
Whoa, what do we got? Malavon is right there. All right. Oh, and he appears to be putting up. Oh, wow, that is a lot. Stone skin, mirror image, globe of invulnerability, blur, shield. Yeah. Okay. Okay. What do we have that we could do? I don't know if I've actually memorized any of the like spell thrust thingies. Yeah, kind of haven't. What about you? Do you have any of them? Not really. Alright, well, in that case, you don't need to be equipped with that anymore, but I think I want you to be equipped with, well... Yeah, it's not actually going to do anything. Let's go with that. Alright, well, you are moving away.
So your life is
forfeit. Wait, what is that? Oh, an invisible stalker. I think I'm just going to keep Magic Missile and the Invisible Stalker. Using a scroll? Alright, the Invisible Stalker's death. Dead. Not sure what scroll he's using. Invisible Stalker takes 3 poison damage from Iron Golem. What? Oh, there's an Invisible Stalker back there. Well, let's see. Let's try that. Are you... teleporting somewhere? You teleported somewhere. There's another invisible stalker. Oh, there are quite a few invisible stalkers. Ignore him for now. I don't know exactly where you're going. There is a web effect down here. Oh, did you just get a... That's a hit. Probably still has a,
Yes.
Stone skin up. Let's see if the acid effect works, though. Let's do that. Nope. There we go. All right, run over here. Malavon has magic resistance in effect.
Agreed.
Spell failed. Casting... Yeah, he is taking some acid damage. That is good. And it looks like he just, what are you taking poison damage from? Alright, target gone. You are over here. Okay.
Your command?
You had need of me?
Of course.
Forward! To victory! Make peace with your gods. That sounds reasonable. I'm here. On it. Watch me run!
You're webbing again. That's not doing all that much for us, but, oh! Hey, it looks like we killed him. 50,000 experience points for that. I'm good. I'm good with that. Let's take that, 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 and that. And regroup up here. Retreat. Oh, wow. 337,500 experience points. Alright, let's see. Robe of the Watcher. Made for a dark elf wizard from Malavon, the Robe of the Watcher is recognized among Drow as a sign of great power. It is traditionally worn by the most talented practitioner of divination magic in Relavan's Academy of Sorcery. Malavon was awarded the robe when he was still in good graces with his city. Armor class 3, save versus spell, plus 2... non-detectable by magical means such as detect invisibility and scrying, immune to Umberhulk gaze, magic resistance plus 10%. That is actually pretty good. How does that compare to this? That's just plus 2. That is better armor class protection. Yeah, I'll stick with that. Alright, so we lose one first level spell, but that's okay. Yeah, I think I'm good with that. Let's go ahead and put that away. Malavon's Rage, 7th level spell. Malavon's Rage was created by the dark elf sorcerer Malavon. It shoots darts of pure energy out from the caster's body in all directions, harming friend and foe alike. The small wedges of magic do 20d4 points of piercing damage, save versus spell for half, to everything caught in their path. The spell is especially useful when a wizard is surrounded by enemies. Yeah, you think? Well... it's actually probably better for her. Can she cast 7th level spells yet? No. Alright, but I think I will go for that. I think I will give that to her. And let's see. Fire Kiss plus 3. This thick blade was originally crafted by Darrow deep beneath the surface of Faerun. Owned by Savant Debont, Fire Kiss was rarely put to use. Debont relied upon magical traps and torture to amuse himself instead. Eventually, Debont was killed by a mob of hook horrors who kept the dagger in a pile with all of their other refuse. 30 years later, Mind Flayers destroyed the hook horrors and took the dagger back to their community. The merchant Nim traded deep gnome slaves to the Mind Flayers in exchange for the dagger, which was eventually sold to Malavon. 5% chance hit target is affected by Shroud of Flame, 2d6 fire damage. Eh. Put it away. And Malavon's badge.
Very well.
Not exactly sure what the purple crap is.
Acknowledged.
Robe of the Evil Archmagi. That should sell for a pretty penny. These axes will sell for absolutely nothing, but hey, I've got a bag of holding. Oh, yeah, that's... that is the only thing. Let's go search that. Oh, there's also a room down there. Ow! That is painful. Alright, I think I might want you in here. Detecting traps. And there's the fatigue.
Let me find some place to set camp.
Alright. Doesn't look like... that looks like there's a bug in the effect for that one right there.
I am prepared. Understood. I am exhausted.
Bunch of spell scrolls. Let's see. The ring is... Ring of Aura Transfusion. A ring... increased regeneration, 1 hit point every 3 seconds, magic resistance minus 5%, save versus spell minus 2. Well, I'm not sure what magic resistance minus 5% would mean if you have no magic resistance in the first place. Who can wear it? Not usable by bards, clerics, druids, fighters, monks, rangers, paladins, thieves. Might think about that. Let's see. Death Fog. That's probably one of those. What's cast? Death Spell. Disintegrate. Shades. Let's see. Amulet of Dark Flesh. A horrible cursed item created by the Kalashite necromancer Neri Eden. The Amulet of Dark Flesh is a token of disease and slow death. Eden gave the item to his secret enemies as gifts and reclaimed it through his thief servants when the sickness had run its course. Neri is believed to still be alive somewhere in the realms, despite the fact that he was a human born in 832 DR. Wearer is paralyzed and diseased. 1 damage every 5 seconds. Can only be removed with a remove curse spell. Well, I guess that's getting put away there. Let's see. Power word kill. Chain contingency. Let's actually see if we can get everyone in here.
Oh, the demons of sleep hound me.
Yeah. We'll get to it. Don't worry.
I am by your side, indeed.
Alright, you're full up on stuff right now. But we've got Potion of Absorption. Potion of Cold Resistance. Potion of Genius. Potion of Defense. Two Potions of Invisibility. Two Potions of Fire Breath. I never ever use these. let's see. Hand over all of the scrolls to Ellie so that she can put them away.
I'm on it.
Take that. Take the rest of those, and let's see. There's just this left. Alright, we've got a Oil of Null Effect. An Oil of Null Effect. Dispels magical effects on the drinker. This potion is the result of Darrow Savant's meddling in magical unguents. When it is smeared over the body of a living creature, it will nullify all magical effects, including all curses, contingencies, and Gia spells. Interesting. Potion of Invulnerability. I think this is a fake? The liquid in the potion has a strange murky quality to it that you haven't noticed in other potions. Yeah, I have a feeling that that's fake. Let's see, we've got absolute immunity, flesh to stone, tensor's transformation, hope, and monster summoning 7. As well as seeds. These seeds come from some of the rarest tropical plants that seem to be able to grow in very unfavorable climates and conditions. Aha! So that's for, back at the severed hand, I am guessing. Let's go ahead and put these spell scrolls away. You can really put a lot of scrolls into the scroll case. In there. Now, was there anything else?
Right.
Nope. Nope. I meant you.
Understood.
Yes. Did I get everything else? Nope. Alright. Alright, so we've got mass invisibility. Finger of Death. And Cacophiend. As well as 2 potions of magic protection. Her inventory is full. And a potion of magic shielding. I don't know why it's so finicky with that picking up of items. Alright, so we got a lot of scrolls there. Nothing all that fantastic otherwise. Looked at everything. Oh, whoops. Simulacrum. Okay. Nothing else there. Nothing else over there. Nope. Alright. That, I think that does it. Let's go ahead and shake that bag first. There we go. What do we get? 20 bolts. Plus 1, I think. Yep, bolts plus 1. Alright. Let's take a look at Simulacrum real fast. A duplicate of the caster is created with a spell. The duplicate is almost identical to the caster, making it a very powerful ally. It is created at 50% of the caster's level and has all the spells and abilities that the caster would have at that level. It also has 75% of the caster's hit points and is fully under his control. Hmm. That's pretty nice. I may have to memorize that. Do we have 8th level spells? We do. That would be a lot better than Summon Fiend, I think. But we will think about that next time. See you then, everyone.